Hey guys, thank you so much for joining us today. We're so excited that you have been a part of our Because You Ask series. This is where we answer some of your questions that you guys might have about our program. We're going to be going inside just a minute to sit down with our executive director and pastor, Paul Pruitt, and he's going to be tackling the questions that you guys have. As always, we thank you so much for liking us on Facebook. Thank you for liking us on YouTube. If you have not done that, please do so. You can go to our Facebook page, just search Bethel Colony of Mercy. You can also go on YouTube and search us there, and you can find these videos that will be linked there, also linked within our Facebook. If you're looking to sow into our ministry, you can do so at BethelColony.org. You also can go at Facebook and sow there as well. We're so glad that you're a part of this. Come inside, let's sit down, let's talk a little bit, and let's go over some of these questions that you guys might have. Hey everyone, thank you again for joining us today. This is our Because You Ask series where we are tackling the questions you guys have. And we're so thankful that you guys have joined us this morning. Today we're going to be hitting on a question, Pastor Pruitt, that has been asked, and it's about getting your GED here at Bethel. A lot of people ask that, pose those questions. You know, that's part of our application as we're coming in. We're finding out if they've been to high school, if they've got their GED. A lot of people ask, why do we do that?
Right.
The question is, someone told me that I haven't graduated from high school, that Bethel will make me work on a GED, and why is that?
Yeah, good question. There's quite a few good reasons for that, and I understand that when people come, they aren't necessarily expecting that to be a part of the program,
right.
While they're here. And we got some good answers for that. Part of the reason there, as you leave here, one of the things you're going to be looking for is employment.
Mm-hmm.
And even if you're currently employed, earning your GED certificate will increase your number of quality jobs that you can get. And some people haven't thought about this, that when people look to move up, whether it be in a management position, and they go back and review if it's a corporate or even a larger company that like Walmart, they're going to go back and pull back past information
right. And
see, do you have a high school diploma?
Right.
Do you have a GED? And that could limit you in moving up in that company that you've been working for a long time, or pass up on promotions or raises. So that's one of the reasons that is in your benefit. The other is self-esteem. You think about, you've worked on this for X amount of years of your life. Good people, a good number of people probably put in 10 years or more on working on their high school diploma before, and then whatever reason they left school. And when you go and work on something that long and you didn't complete it, it tends to bring down some self-esteem.
Right.
You feel less of yourself. And so setting that goal and achieving that goal and finally fulfilling something that you worked on so long of your life, it's going to make you feel better about yourself.
Mm-hmm.
I've had many who sat down and figured out that was part of the system that here at Bethel Colony, and be just really questioned because they didn't want to do it. Didn't matter what answer I give them. They just mm-hmm. didn't want to do it. But when they got done and they completed it, they were excited
yeah.
and said how much better they felt about themselves
yep.
for finishing this. Another reason is being a role model. Most of us have kids there, or going to have kids, and planning their future is usually education involved.
Right.
And they ask those questions about our education. They ask those questions about why didn't we complete, or and so on there. So being that good role model and earning your GED certificate shows them the value of your education, helps them understand the value of their education, and expecting them to do well as
right.
well. The other thing you want to think about is your personal education. If you're wanting to go to college, if you're wanting to, who knows, while you're here, you may figure out you've been called into ministry, or you want to help somebody else in counseling and help them overcome substance abuse. And if you're wanting to do that, the course of having your GED completed is the beginning.
Right.
You can't go on in college until you've done that. So to move up in that process, you're going to need that. Also, our teacher here in our GED program is an excellent teacher,
mm-hmm.
excellent teacher. Matter of fact, we talked yesterday, I think it was, or Monday, and he had a list of all the graduates this year, and comparing it to the local GED program here in our community college. We got more graduates here.
That's awesome. At Bethel, that's awesome.
Than the community college. So one of the things he does differently is he gets in, he tests them, and he figures out where the weak point is that they need, and he starts building them up and doing practice tests. And it tends to be a more of an accelerated process here at Bethel because the window of 65 days is the goal that he's trying to get it done. And even if somebody doesn't get it done in the 65 days, usually there are only one or two tests left. Right. And if they've been local, they've been able to come back and work with our GED teacher and continue to get it done. And last but not least, understand that we are disciples. And to know more of our word, we've got to have some of the basics to be able to study, to have the self-discipline to read, to have the self-discipline to study. The better we are at reading, the better we are at English, the better we understand the word that we're reading there and other study tools that we have. It helps us to better communicate what we're learning and to others about our faith. And think about this. Jesus himself, the Bible says about Jesus himself that he grew in wisdom, stature, and in favor with God. He grew in wisdom. Right. He continued to grow in knowledge and wisdom there. And 2 Timothy tells us, chapter 2, verse number 15, says, "Be diligent to present yourselves approved to God, a worker who does not need to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth." And so that worker is somebody who studies, and we need to understand basic principles of our education to be a good study there.
It's good.
So there's some good reasons.
Yeah, and you know, and that also applies with just GED, but, you know, you're talking about good studies. You're coming into this program, you're coming to learn, you're coming to grasp what Bethel Colony is trying to instill into you. So you're going to be given a workbook, you're going to be given other things, material here that you're going to be working on. So you know, it's good to be just focused on every bit of it, all the aspects. So make sure that you're devoted to that. Also, the GED here at Bethel, we're actually one of the only two places here in Caldwell County that still does that.
Yeah.
So that's pretty amazing that, you know, we still can do that and be, have them come and be a part of something here from the college. Yeah. And we're thankful for that. Thankful that the college comes in and offers their time to do that. So, thank you again, Pastor Pritt, for answering that. Again, guys, thank you so much for joining us and watching these videos. We always are so glad that you guys stop in and just take the time to watch these. As always, share these videos, share them with people that who are looking to come in this program. You yourself might be looking to come in. Make sure you're sharing this with those that you love and you care about. Liking our Facebook page, subscribing to our YouTube channel, go on there. There's a playlist below, and when you get in YouTube, tons of information that you guys can go check out about what this program offers. How to prepare for coming in here. So we ask that you go there if you have any questions and see if you can't find some of those that's already been answered. Yeah. So again, thank you again for joining us today. We look forward to seeing you next time.
Right.